Welcome everyone. In the next lecture on complex integration, this previous lecture we have discussed the Laurent series, Taylor series, and singularities and its types. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss what is meant by a residue and how to calculate the residue for a given particular complex valued function at a given pole. Okay. So first, I am going to define the residues. So first we are going to define what is residues. If z is equal to z naught is an isolated singularity, then the constant b1, b1 in Lorentz expansion that is coefficient of 1 upon z minus z naught in Lorentz expansion of f of z at z is equal to 0. So the coefficient of 1 upon z minus z naught is called as a residue. F of z at z is equal to 0. So now there are various ways of calculating the residues. So few rules I am going to discuss here. The first rule, see, if always we are calculating the Laurent series at z is equal to z naught and defining the residue, will take a lot of time. So instead of that, we will discuss a few simple rules by which you can easily calculate the residue of the given function. So the first is the isolated singularity is nothing but pole. So I mention here z is equal to z naught b simple pole. It is pole of order 1. Then residue of f of z at z is equal to z naught is equal to limit z tends to z naught of z minus z naught into f of z. Second rule, if z is equal to z naught b simple pole, be the simple pole and f of z is of type. Of f of z is equal to p of z upon q of z. So f of z, which is given in the form of p of z upon q of z, then its pole will be, its residue will be given as residue of f of z at z is equal to z naught is limit z tends to z naught of p of z upon q dash of z. And now third rule, if z is equal to z naught b pole of order n, then residue of f of z at z is equal to z naught is equal to 1 upon n minus 1 factorial into limit z tends to z naught of d raised to m minus 1, sorry, not m, it's n, d raised to n minus 1 upon dz raised to n minus 1, that is n minus 1th order derivative of z minus z naught raised to n into f. Okay, so these are the three working rules for calculating the residue of the given function. So I am first going to define one simple example where I am trying to follow the Lorentz expansion to discuss the residue. Okay, so let's begin with a simple example. Okay, mention the question. Find, find the residue of f of z is equal to 1 upon z minus sine z at its singularity. At its singularity by using Lorentz series expansion. By using the Lorentz series expansion. Okay. Now, first thing is, what is the pole of this function? Any guesses? What is the pole of the function? The function f of z is equal to 1 upon z minus sine z. The pole is z is equal to 0. And what is its order? Yes, of course, the order is 1, so it's a simple pole. So now how can I expand this as a Lorentz expansion? It's very easy. This is 1 upon z minus sine z. What is the series of sine z? The series of sine z is z minus z cube upon 3 factorial plus z raised to 5 upon 5 factorial minus and so on. So this is equals to, now what? This is a plus z, and when I give the minus sign inside, it is minus z. So plus z minus z cancel. Hence, I am getting z cube upon 3 factorial plus z raised to 5 upon 5 factorial minus z raised to 7 upon 7 factorial plus and so on. So now one can rewrite this as 1 upon, I am taking z cube upon 3 factorial as a common. So z cube upon 3 factorial into bracket 1 plus, as z cube upon 3 factorial is going outside, that means here I am having z raised to 5, which becomes z square upon. Now there is a term 5 factorial. 5 factorial can be written as 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. So I am taking this 3 factorial out, so we get 5 fours are 20 in the denominator place. Is it? Okay, I'm just taking this minus sign inside. So here I'm getting, I just did one mistake here for the signs. Need to be corrected. So this has to be minus. Then z has to 7. And so on. So 1 plus z square plus 20 plus and so on. So now what I'm getting? I'm getting the f of z as 3 factorial, that is 6 upon z cube into bracket 1 plus z square upon 20 plus z raised to 7. So how much is going outside? Z raised to 7. Z cube is going outside. So how much remains? Z raised to 4 upon 7 factorial. 7 factorial can be written as 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. So this 3 factorial is going outside. So the product of this 5 fours are 20, 20 multiplied by 7 into 6. Yes, what will be the answer? 20 multiplied by 7 into 6. Answer is 840. So here I am getting 840 in the denominator plus and so on. Rest to minus 1. Now just look at this factor. This is something like 1 plus variable rest to minus 1. Is it? And the mod z is less than infinity, so we can easily expand this function. Yes or no? Yes, we can easily expand this. So in the expansion, what I'm getting? I'm getting 6 upon z cube into bracket 1 plus, sorry, not 1 plus, it's a 1. I'm making the same mistakes here. I'm keeping the minus sign outside, so this becomes minus, this becomes a minus. See, I'm taking the minus sign common from here. So as I'm taking the minus sign common, the first term, which is actually a positive, this z raised to 5 upon 20 becomes negative term. So that becomes a positive, the next term becomes a negative. Now it's correct. Now what is the expansion of 1 minus z inverse? The expansion of 1 minus z inverse is 1 plus z square plus and so on like that. So I'm just trying to 1 plus z. Now z is nothing but this bracket. So we have z square upon 20 minus. Minus z raised to 4 upon 840 plus and so on plus the same bracket square and so on. Is it? Now I'm multiplying by 6 upon z cube inside of this bracket. We get 6 upon z cube as the first term plus z square upon z cube gives me 1 upon 20 as it is. In the numerator, we get a 6. Now z square upon z cube is 1 upon z. Minus the next term is z raised to 4. Z raised to 4 upon z cube gives me z upon 840. 6 plus and so on like that. Now what? The from the definition, the residue is coefficient of 1 upon z minus n. So here z naught is 0. So 1 minus 1 upon z minus 0, which is nothing but 1 upon z. Just have a look at this particular term. This is my 1 upon z minus z naught. So from this, residue of f of z at z is equal to 0 is equal to coefficient of 1 upon z minus z naught, that is coefficient of 1 upon z. And that coefficient is 6 by 20. So one can simplify this. 2 3s are 6, 2 10s are 20. Are you clear with this? So this is how one can calculate the residue by using the definition. Now we are going with the those three formulas which we have discussed previously. I'm just going to mention the problem here. Find residues of f of z is equal to sine pi z upon z minus 1 square into z minus 2 at its pole. Okay, this is the question. Here What are the poles? Equate the denominator with 0 and tell me what are the poles here. The poles would be z is equal to 1, b, the pole of order. What is the order of the pole? See the bracket power. It is 2. So it is a pole of order 2. And the second pole, z is equal to 2, b, simple pole. Is it? Now, residue of f of z at z is equal to 1. Residue of f of z at z is equal to 1 is equal to. Now, what is the formula? Here the pole of order is 2. So, we have n minus 1 factorial into limit z tends to z naught of d raised to n minus 1 upon dz raised to n minus 1 of z minus z naught raised to n into f. This is the formula for nth of pole of order n. So here n is 2. So we get 1 upon 2 minus 1 factorial into limit z tends to 1 d raised to 2 minus 1 upon dz raised to 2 minus 1 into z minus 1 square into f of z, that is sine pi z divided by z minus 1 square into z minus 2. So these terms are going to cancel. So 1 upon 2 minus 1 factorial is 1 itself. So limit z tends to 1 d by dz of what? Sine pi z upon z minus 2. So we are interested in getting this derivative. So this is numerator upon denominator. So we have limit z tends to 1 of, see the denominator as it is, into derivative of the numerator, that is cos pi z into derivative of pi z is pi, minus numerator as it is into derivative of the denominator, that is 1 divided by denominator square. Got it? So this is, now get a limit. Limit as z tends to 1, we get 1 minus 2 into sine pi z become, sorry, not sine, it's a cos pi z. The z is 1, so we get cos 1 into pi minus sine pi into z is 1 divided by 1 minus 2 square. So 1 minus 2 is minus 1. Now this is cos 1 pi, that is cos pi is minus 1 into pi, minus the sine pi is 0 divided by 1 minus 2 square, that is minus 1 square, minus 1 square is 1. So what is the answer here? Yes, the residue is pi. Now there is one more pole, we are going to discuss the residue of it. Now residue of f of z at z is equal to 2 is equal to. Now see, your pole is of order 1. So we follow the first rule or second rule. But in the second rule, what is expected? In the second rule, we required the, see the second rule. What is expected here? F of z must be in the form of p of z upon q of z. That means your numerator and the denominator should have the algebraic polynomials. Though there is an algebraic polynomial or not, you may follow the first rule for all the conditions. If the pole is of order 1, then you can use the first rule for all the functions. But more specifically, if the function is of type p of z upon q of z, you can use the second rule also. Got it? But here, in all the problems, I am trying to go with the first rule itself. So this is z minus 2 into f of z, which is limit z tends to 2 sine pi z divided by z minus 1 square into z minus 2 and this z minus 2 as it is. So this z minus 2 get cancelled. Now take a limit as z tends to 2, we get 2 minus 1 square into sine pi into 2, which is nothing but sine 2 pi and sine 2 pi is 0. So the residue in the case of second pole is 0. Got it? So this is the simple problems based on the residues. In the next lecture, I am going to discuss the Cauchy residue theorem. That means we are going to solve the problems based on the complex integration where the Cauchy residue theorem is applicable. So in all such cases, there is a very important role of calculation of the residues. So you must be perfect in this. Hence, I am providing you some simple questions to work out the residues of the given function at their poles. So first function which I am interested to give you is find residues of f of z is equal to z upon z minus 1 into z plus 2 square at its pole by using the formula. Okay, using the formula you have to solve this example. Fine. So we'll meet in the next lecture, that is with the topic Cauchy residue theorem. Fine. So thank you everyone.